So hello everyone and welcome back once again to the session of PIP 247 where we are going to discuss some more questions from the PIP news which are relevant for the ESI section of RBI Grade B and NABARD. So let's begin with the session guys, but before we begin, if you are coming here for the first time, you have to subscribe to this channel and you should press this bell icon to get all the latest notifications regarding the latest videos. And you can also join guys this Telegram group for daily quizzes and updated information about the daily sessions, right? So let's begin with the very first question, which is about the National Startup Advisory Council. So you have to consider the following statements regarding National Startup Advisory Council and you have to identify the correct statements out of these three, okay? So in National Startup Advisory Council, uske regarding the statements given, aapko correct statements identify karna hai, alright? So let us first talk about this National Startup Advisory Council. Now the question is, why we are discussing about the National Startup Advisory Council? So about this, I will tell you later. First of all, let's talk about the council. So this National Startup Advisory Council was constituted by the Government of India in the month of January 2020. 2020, in the month of January, this National Startup Advisory Council was set up by the Government of India. Now, what was the objective for setting up this council? To advise the government on measures that are needed to build a strong ecosystem for innovation and startup in our country. हमारे देश का जो innovation है और जो हमारे देश के startup related ecosystem है, उसको advise करने के लिए कि उस ecosystem को कैसे बेहतर बनाया जा सकता है, उसके लिए this National Startup Advisory Council was constituted in the month of January 2020 by the Government of India. Right? And what about its composition? What is its composition? So it is chaired by the Union Minister of Commerce and Industry, which is currently Mr. Piyush Goyal. Piyush Goyal, all right. And who is the convener? It's Joint Secretary from the Department for Promotion of Industry and Internal Trade. Now there are some ex officio members which are nominees from the various department, ministries or organization, and there are some non-official members also which are nominated by the central government. So non-official members are nominated by the central government for a period of 2 years. 2 saalon tak ke liye unko nominate kiya jayega and they can also be expelled before this 2 years. 2 saal se pehle unko hataya bhi ja sakta hai. Okay. And this council is in news because recently government has nominated various members in this non-official member category. Okay. Government ne bahut sare non-official members ko appoint kiya hai in the National Startup Advisory Council. And among them, some important ones are Mr. Baiju Ravindran has been appointed, Mr. Kunal Behl. Mr. Kunal Behl from Snapdeal is also appointed in this National Startup Advisory Council. Alright. So I hope this National Startup Advisory Council is clear. Now you can easily answer this question. So statement number one is, it was constituted by Government of India in the year 2019. So was that 2019? No, it's 2020. It is chaired by Union Minister of Electronics and IT. No, it is not chaired by Union Minister of Electronics and IT. It's the Union Minister of Commerce and Industry, which means this statement is also incorrect. The non-official members are nominated for a period of 3 years. That's not 3 years, that's 2 years. So which means this statement is also incorrect. And we have to find the correct statement. Therefore, option D, none is correct, will be the correct answer. So I hope guys this question is clear. And now let's move on to question number two, which is about an MOU. With which organization TRIFED has signed an MOU to promote livelihood generation of tribal people? Livelihood generation tribal people ka promote karne ke liye kaun si organization ke saath MOU sign kiya gaya hai? So let's discuss about this. So this organization guys is IFMDC, and IFMDC stands for Indian Farm Forestry Development Cooperative Limited. It is basically a multi-state cooperative society which is being promoted by IFCO. इसको कौन प्रमोट कर रहा है? इफको. एंड इट वाज एस्टैब्लिश्ड इन द ईयर 1983 में इसको एस्टैब्लिश किया गया था टू मिटिगेट द क्लाइमेट चेंज को मिटिगेट करने के लिए, देयर बाय क्रिएटिंग अपॉर्चुनिटीज फॉर द ट्राइबल्स, फॉर द पुअर पीपल्स, फॉर द वुमेन. दिस कोऑपरेटिव सोसाइटी वाज लॉन्च्ड इन द ईयर 19 वाज एस्टैब्लिश्ड इन द ईयर 1983. ऑलराइट. एंड टॉकिंग अबाउट दिस एमओयू, सो गाइस दिस एमओयू हैज बीन साइन फॉर कंडक्टिंग ट्रेनिंग प्रोग्राम्स फॉर ट्राइबल आर्टिसंस इन द फील्ड ऑफ entrepreneurship skills and business development. Entrepreneurship skill dene ke liye aur business development ke liye this MOU has been signed between TRIFED and IFMDC. And remember, IFMDC is the Indian Farm Forestry Development Cooperative Society, which is being promoted by if को, राइट. सो देयरफॉर द करेक्ट आंसर शुड बी ऑप्शन बी, IFFDC, इंडियन फार्म फॉरेस्ट्री डेवलपमेंट कॉर्पोरेशन. ओके, एंड नाउ लेट्स मूव ऑन टू क्वेश्चन नंबर 3. Which state has become the first state to implement power sector reforms as stipulated by the Department of Expenditure, Ministry of Finance? So I hope you all remember about the four reforms that were told by the Ministry of Finance. One is One Nation, One Ration Card. One is the Ease of Doing Business Reforms. Then we have Local Body Reforms. And then we have power sector reforms. So power sector reforms में सबसे पहला state कौन बना है? It's Madhya Pradesh. Alright, so let me tell you the answer here. It's Madhya Pradesh which has taken the lead in implementing the power sector reforms in the state. Alright, so let's talk more about this. So Madhya Pradesh has taken the lead in implementing the power sector reforms. As I told you, now let's talk about these power sector reforms. ये basically power sector reforms में क्या-क्या बातें कही थी government ने? So 0.05% of GSDP, gross state domestic product. So 0.05% of gross state domestic will be provided to that state for reduction in aggregate technical and commercial losses in the power sector. Power sector में जो भी technical और commercial losses है, अगर वो कम कर देगा वो state, then 0.05% of GSDP will be provided to that state as a financial grant from the Ministry of Finance, right? And moving ahead, 0.05% of GSDP will be provided for reduction in the gap between what? Between average cost of supply and average revenue realization in the power sector in that particular state. And Madhya Pradesh has completed this number third power sector reforms. Okay, isme kya hai? 0.15% of GSDP of the state will be provided on introduction of direct benefit transfer in the field of electricity subsidy to the farmers. जो फार्मर्स है उनको जो इलेक्ट्रिसिटी सब्सिडी दी जाती है, इफ दैट सब्सिडी विल बी प्रोवाइडेड थ्रू डायरेक्ट बेनिफिट ट्रांसफर, देन इट विल बी काउंटेड इन द पावर सेक्टर रिफॉर्म्स, एंड फॉर दैट 0.15% ऑफ जीएसडीपी विल बी प्रोवाइडेड एज द ग्रांट फ्रॉम द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ फाइनेंस, राइट. सो आई होप गाइस दिस इज क्लियर. एंड नाउ एमपी जो है मध्य प्रदेश वो पहला स्टेट बना है बिकॉज मध्य प्रदेश हैज लॉन्च्ड डायरेक्ट बेनिफिट ट्रांसफर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिसिटी सब्सिडी टू फार्मर्स इन विदिशा डिस्ट्रिक्ट में दिसंबर 2020 में मध्य प्रदेश ने डायरेक्ट बेनिफिट ट्रांसफर स्कीम लॉन्च कर दिया गया था टू प्रोवाइड इलेक्ट्रिसिटी सब्सिडी टू फार्मर्स. एंड देन दे हैव रिसेंटली लॉन्च्ड दिस डीबीटी स्कीम इन टू मोर डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स विच आर झबुआ एंड सियोनी. ऑलराइट, झबुआ एंड सियोनी. एंड आफ्टर द सक्सेसफुल इंप्लीमेंटेशन ऑफ दिस स्कीम इन दीज थ्री डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स, मध्य प्रदेश गवर्नमेंट हैज प्लान्ड टू लॉन्च दिस स्कीम इन द होल स्टेट from the financial year 2021-22, which means the next financial year. अगले financial year से this scheme will be implemented in whole state, in whole Madhya Pradesh, right? So therefore guys, here the correct answer is what? Madhya Pradesh. Option B, Madhya Pradesh is the correct answer. Chief Minister is Shivraj Singh Chauhan. Shivraj Chauhan is the Chief Minister, and recently Gwalior and Orcha have got the UNESCO World Heritage City tag, and other than this, there are other UNESCO World Heritage sites also in Madhya Pradesh. Like for example, we have Khajuraho group of monuments. Then we have Bhimbetka Rock Cut Caves. All right. And talking more about Madhya Pradesh, so Madhya Pradesh is the first state to establish a Gau cabinet. Cow cabinet बनाने वाले पहला state है मध्य प्रदेश, and you will find Kanha National Park in मध्य प्रदेश, you will find Bandhavgarh National Park in मध्य प्रदेश, you will find Satpura Tiger Reserve in मध्य प्रदेश, and etc. Alright, so therefore the correct answer here guys is what? मध्य प्रदेश. And now let's move on to question number 4 guys, which is based on a government scheme because there were very less current affairs news from the PIB. So I took a question from government scheme, and after reading the passage you have to identify the name of this scheme. Alright. So, program was launched by Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change in 2017. So, whenever this type of question comes, you have to look out for the hints. Kya hints is paragraph mein given hai about the scheme. So, the very first hint is what? It is being implemented by the Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change. It was launched in the year 2015. So, already two important hints are already we have identified. where the government is developing skills of youth in the field of environment and forest sectors, which means the basic objective is also given, where the basic objective is what? Through this scheme, the government wants to develop skills of youth in the field of environment and forest sectors, right? So, three hints are there. Then, there are more than 30 courses which can be availed through this program. So, one more fact about that scheme. And the program is being implemented by utilizing the vast networks and expertise of environmental information system. So, guys, there are various hints that are being that has been provided in this question. So, I hope you can easily identify the scheme now. Let me tell you the answer now. The correct answer to this question, guys, is option C, Green Skill Development Program. और इस स्कीम में इससे ज़्यादा पढ़ने का कुछ भी नहीं है. This paragraph tells you a lot about this scheme, is this program. इस प्रोग्राम में इससे ज़्यादा हमें पढ़ने की ज़रूरत नहीं है. Okay? So क्या क्या पढ़ना है? The scheme is launched by the Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change in the year 2017 to develop skills skills of youth in the field of environment and forest sector. All right. So I hope, guys, this question is clear. Its answer is Green Skill Development Program. Okay, and I hope all the questions are clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye, take care, and God bless.